So the Foo Fighters, a band that has influenced me in a number of ways that I've only seen once in my life. I hope to see them again. It won't be the same now that Taylor's gone, but still, if I'm able to see the Foo Fighters on tour again, that'll be worth it, and I think it'll be something special, especially as they honor the memory of Taylor. I remember when Foo Fighters first came out, I wasn't that big of a fan of them. The first self-titled album, the songs, I liked, but they didn't really resonate with me. I really didn't make the connect. It makes so much of the connection that this was the former Nirvana drummer turned lead singer, guitarist. That wasn't an issue for me. But really, by the time The Color and The Shape came out, something started clicking. And the more that I listened to them, and I think the album that really started, really sunk its teeth into me, it was the album Echo, Silence, Patience, and Grace. That was the album that really connected with me in a way that, and the Foo Fighters were really connecting with me in a way that I did not see coming. Dave's overall influence, and I think that when we started seeing him doing so much more, especially behind the camera, when he was doing his documentaries, watching those documentaries, whether it was, you know, for that working on their album Sonic Highways, that whole 8-part documentary, one show for every song. Gosh, I want to go back and watch that. I hope it's still available on HBO. The Foo Fighters had, they had the rock and roll that I feel like I had started missing. You know, they're still an active rock and roll band, whereas, you know, REM doesn't tour anymore. Well, they've broken up. They won't reform and retour anymore. Rush doesn't tour anymore. Cayman's Call, I will get a chance to see them. But for the most part, they're a band that doesn't really tour anymore. And all my influences are people who don't tour anymore because either they're done or members of the band have deceased. Neil Peart and Rush, Tom Petty, I'll be doing a video on Tom Petty. He's unfortunately passed on. So a lot of my influences I can't see anymore. And so the Foo Fighters I still can. And there's that connection to them. There's that connection to Dave, who plays multiple instruments. And I think back when I was working on my first album, Make Something Happen Here, it wasn't a full Dave Grohl type production. I didn't play all the instruments. I couldn't, but I did play a lot of the instruments. Guitar, bass, piano. I didn't play the drums. I didn't play lead guitar, but I did a lot of the other stuff, or at least I wrote parts for them. To me, I felt that was kind of like my Dave Grohl moment. I resonate with him as a human being because he's so energetic. He loves music, and he loves the people that he works with. He's very loyal. As it is, he's a very loyal person to his cause and to all the stuff that he's worked towards. I respect him as a human. I respect him as a musician. I respect him as a filmmaker, in both in front and behind the camera. Now, I haven't seen Studio 666. The concept of that seems so corny to me that they probably had way too much fun with it, but I should probably check it out at some point. Probably will. But yeah, the Foo Fighters, they've had a big influence on me, and you can hear that on the first album, especially with the lead track, Maybe It's Time. You can hear the Foo Fighters' influence on that song. You can hear grunge influence on it in other places as well. So yeah, the Foo Fighters, out of all the bands that I love and that I respect, they are big influences on me and have had a big influence on me as a person, as a person who consumes music, and I appreciate that about them. Thank you, Foo Fighters.